Okay, so I was on radio with Charlie, Crabby Dog's Tricks from YouTube. His show is called Wide Awake Radio. We were talking about the economy, and Dex called in, and he was talking about how the mosque story and the burning the Quran story was used to basically divide people. It's basically a side op, and I couldn't agree more. And, you know, I just thought, you know, since I've been applying for these different places for employment, and been trying to get any job that I possibly can, I figure, you know, why don't I apply for a position called I think it's called what is it again? Associate Psychological Warfare Operator, something like that. Basically, it's a psyops position where you're basically an analyst and you're throwing around ideas. Where you're basically trying to distract people, you're constantly trying to divide people. So I thought, you know, this is something that I could really do. And just like the Mosque story and the whole burning the Quran story, and how those stories are used to really divide people, I figured, you know, why don't I take my own experiences and figure out what are some meaningless wedge issues that I could use to distract people. And, you know, here's the first one, a Mosque bird 500, okay? I can do a video on why this is superior to the Remington 870. And it's superior because, well, they're pretty much the same, but it's superior because you have the sights in the front, so when you're actually pointing, you can really see the dot. That alone makes it a lot better than a Remington 870. I'm sure I can divide people on that meaningless issue right here. Here's another one, a Glock 21. Why is a Glock 21 better than a Springfield? Well, because the Springfield has shiny magazines, which could attract a lot of attention in a gunfight. By the way, who in their right mind would even want to be in a gunfight? You know, and plus, it's Springfield is more expensive, and it has sort of like a safety right here, which is completely unnecessary. So I'm sure I can start a debate there. And what about the AK-47 versus AR-15 discussion? I could talk about how the AK-47 is better because it's more durable. It doesn't have the same range, but basically you can throw it in mud and water, and it'll be easier to clean. It'll hold up a lot better and less likely to jam. Or at least I can claim that. I'm sure I can divide people pretty well with that. Let's try to expand upon this. Okay, what do we have right here? Okay, PlayStation 3. Obviously superior to Xbox 360. Because you can play Blu-rays. And it's a lot better with playing videos in general. A lot of times with a 360... you can't even play certain types of videos without being online. It's actually quite strange. I noticed this with my friend. So I like to start debates over what's better, PlayStation 3 or Xbox 360. Obviously, PlayStation 3 is better because you can play Blu-rays, and it actually uses Blu-rays, so you can get more data on a disc, which means you can get much better graphics with PlayStation 3 in the long run. So obviously that's a lot better. You know, why not plasma versus LCD? You know, LCD is a lot better. Well, it used to be because you never had to worry about playing video games and having a burn on your screen or anything like that. So that's a good idea. What about Remington? Remington versus Winchester. You know, I want to get some more of your ideas for meaningless debates that do not affect people's lives. And basically, I'm going to apply for this position. By the way, there is no such position, but I just want to get some of your ideas, because the whole mall situation, building a mosque a couple blocks from the World Trade Center, how's that going to affect anybody's life? I mean, come on, it's ridiculous. It's just used as a wedge issue. Dex, you're 100% right. A real Christian would not be trying to put down another religion by burning a Quran. Why is anybody listening to this idiot in Florida? Some pastor with, what, I don't know, 50 followers or at best? You know, and I can't believe we have the Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, actually listening to this guy and actually commenting on this guy. I mean, only in America do we listen to the idiots. I mean, in any other country, we would just pretty much ignore these people. But, you know, since we're talking about meaningless wedge issues, I'm going to need your help on coming up with stupid crap to distract people from the fact that there's 41 million people on food stamps, meaningless crap to distract people from the fact that we have continued unemployment, about a half a million people applying for unemployment last week for the first time. You know, these are extremely high levels. We're going to need something to distract people from the fact that we now have record foreclosures, record bankruptcies. Houses, the housing market is pretty much done. I mean, it's going to be years, many years before that recovers. We still have to deal with option arm. We're still looking at commercial real estate going down. We need a distraction. So I need some distraction ideas from you guys, and so I can come up with some more goofy stories. Just like the clowns in the mainstream media has been working on coming up with ridiculous stories to distract you from the things that really matter. So I'm accepting your ideas, and wish me luck on this imaginary job. Bye.